Dr. Bill Bailey, and this is the Vert Zine Netcast. Vert Zine is the online magazine of virtualization and cloud computing, and I'm glad you could join us for this edition of the Vert Zine Netcast. We're going to dive right in to some of the news of the week, but before we do, I want to mention we are proud members of the Tech Podcast Network, techpodcast.com. If it's tech, it's right here on the Vert Zine Netcast and all the other great tech podcasts that are out there on TPN. I'm telling you, a bunch of good folks out there, and they're doing a great job of promoting Tech Podcast Network. You can get Vert Zine on the Blueberry Network through the Roku box, Tech Podcast Network through the Roku and Boxy and Apple TV and all kinds of other devices, and now Samsung smart TVs and just all kinds of devices that you can get the Vert Zine Netcast through all the TPN and Raw Voice properties. And I'm telling you what, like I say, Todd Cochran and the gang, they're doing a great job there. So we are excited to be part of Tech Podcast. Now let's look at the news that we have blogged about since the last Vert Zine Netcast. VM Turbo wins an award. VM Turbo wins the Search Server Virtualization.com's Product of the Year Award for 2011. Now, I've talked to the VM Turbo guys. We haven't actually gone with the product yet. We're still looking at various products for VMware monitoring and optimization. But I'm telling you what, I'm really impressed with VM Turbo. And if you haven't looked at it, go check out their website. Go to the link here and look at some of the things that they can do. They have upped the capabilities of the product, and they really deserve this award. So appreciate the guys there at VM Turbo. Appreciate you being patient with us as we decide what to do about getting an optimization product. Hang in there. At any rate, you know, we're looking at a lot of different products, and it's a long process in the business world to make some of these kinds of decisions. Anyway, let's also talk about Red Hat Enterprise Virtualization. We've got an article here with a link to an overview of Red Hat Enterprise Virtualization. Now, as you may know, I am a manager of Red Hat at High Point Regional Health System, where I'm a system administrator, and I work with Red Hat extensively, and also with VMware, of course, and Citrix, so a lot of virtualization-type technologies. Red Hat has long been a proponent of virtualization, and they have been building virtualization into their Red Hat Enterprise Linux product. Well, now they've actually taken that and gone even a step further and come out with the Red Hat Enterprise Virtualization product that even makes it a better tool. And what's been lacking has been the management interface tools, and they have taken that up a notch. I was talking about how VM Turbo has taken their software up a notch. Well, Red Hat has done the same thing. They've taken their interfaces up a notch to make it easier to do virtualization through their platform. So I appreciate that. I appreciate them developing their product. And as I've always said, you know, to me, competition is a great thing because it spurs innovation and it spurs companies to keep working toward better and better interfaces, better and better tools, better and better features in their software. And that's a good thing, believe me. Anything that makes our job easier as system administrators, I like it. And not only easier, but also more capabilities, more tools, more, what's the word I'm looking for here? Options to help the basic premise of the need for virtualization, which is keeping our customers, okay, which in this case is patients at a hospital, in my case, and the people who support that, the IT staff, they're also our customers as server administrators, keep that whole paradigm going. So, good stuff. All right, next item we want to talk about is the Amazon Dynamo Database. DynamoDB, they call it. Amazon, as you may know, offers all kinds of cloud capabilities. I've looked at their S3 product, kind of dove into that a little bit, and just to check out how it works and how it might be of use to me personally in terms of storing video online in an S3 account in the buckets that you can create. That's what they call it. That's the term they use, is buckets. So you create a bucket, you put your files in it, and then they have another service called CloudFront that allows you to publish your video or your audio, whatever, various media, to the cloud or through the cloud to other folks throughout the world. And one of the things they do is they have data centers all around the world, and they replicate to those different data centers so that the download will be localized to wherever you are in the world, which will speed up the download dramatically. And it's actually very cool the way it works. So I've been very impressed with that particular product, the S3 product, in conjunction with their CloudFront product. Well, now they have a product called Amazon DynamoDB, and it's big data's next big cloud moment, they call it here. This is what they term it in their article that was written here. But here's what the article says. Amazon Web Services launched the DynamoDB NoSQL database service on Wednesday of this past week, marking the company's boldest appeal yet for companies to trust a cloud-based service as a platform for running a business. The question now is whether Amazon can really deliver big data scale at a reasonable cost through a cloud-based operation. The DynamoDB service is akin to giving Amazon's S3 SimpleDB service a massive boost in terms of capacity and performance. That's because this new service is based on Dynamo, the NoSQL database Amazon developed internally and has been using to run parts of its massive consumer commerce website since 2007. So that's pretty cool. And, you know, this is the kind of technology that a lot of different companies use. I know I used to have a web-based sales company. We sold low-carb foods. It was called the Low Carb Nexus, and we long ago have since closed that. But we had a database on a Linux server. It was actually running CentOS Linux, and then it was MySQL database, and then that powered our shopping cart, which was based on OS Commerce, Oz Commerce, which is open source commerce product. And we had all of our products in there, hundreds and hundreds of them. And then you could order through that whole process. And I managed the server and the DNSs. We had our own internal DNS system. We had our own internal database server and web server running Apache and the whole nine yards. And for years, we had our small business, which actually did a lot of business through the web, and started in, I think it was 1999, so it's good time, a while back. But we were innovative for our day to do that kind of thing. And so I know that this is a tremendous service that that Amazon is offering. Now the question is, will people take them up on it? Will they actually put their data into a cloud-based database for businesses? That's the key, and that's what it's going to take for it to be successful. All right, last item for this particular netcast, Linux adoption grows and increases in cloud and virtualization areas. Now, I just mentioned that I used to run a business based on Linux, based on, in this case, it was CentOS Linux, which is Red Hat Enterprise Linux. Actually, you know what? I take that back. I'm sorry. It really was Red Hat Enterprise Linux. I later went to CentOS, but when I had the store, when we were running our store, we actually had a licensed, full, supported copy of Red Hat Enterprise Linux through Red Hat that that we used for our servers and for our database server and so forth. So we went to CentOS much later. So really was a full-blown Red Hat Enterprise Linux. Boy, how time just flies, you know. You forget these things. Anyway, it struck me because I've been a Red Hat customer for, wow. I've been a Red Hat customer for so long that they actually sent me a letter back a long time ago, back in the 80s, that was a coupon for a free copy of Red Hat because I was one of the first 100 customers ever of Red Hat. And you know what? I didn't redeem the coupon. I actually kept it. I still have it today to be one of the first 100 customers of Red Hat. So, like I said, I go back with Red Hat a long way. All right. A little personal reminiscence there. Linux adoption grows and increases in cloud and virtualization areas. And this is what the article says. A new Linux Foundation survey on enterprise adoption of Linux indicates that growth in Linux usage is being driven by factors such as big data, cloud computing, and virtualization. I lost track of what I was reading here. Okay, here we go. Lost in my own article. The January 2012 report from Linux Foundation and Yeoman Technology Group titled Linux Adoption Trends 2012, a survey of enterprise end users, claims that affinity among new and veteran Linux users continues to increase at the expense of Windows and Unix. Pretty neat. 84% of organizations currently using Linux have expanded its usage over the last 12 months and continue to rely on it as preferred platform for greenfield deployments, as well as mission-critical applications. Now, I know at High Point Regional Health System, we use Linux. We have about 38 Linux servers. We've got probably, I'd say, close to 400 total servers, so it's a percentage. 10%, a little less than 10% of the number of total servers we have running the entire hospital. But all of our critical clinical applications are running on those Red Hat servers, Red Hat Enterprise Linux. And right now, last couple weeks, we've been doing tons of upgrades to upgrade them from Red Hat 4 to Red Hat 5. Now you might say, well, Dr. Bill, Red Hat 6 is out. Tell me about it. But you know how it is in a corporate environment, you move slowly. And so McKesson, our primary vendor for clinical software, has approved us to go to 5.7 of Red Hat, and that's what we've done, is we've been upgrading that. So I can see this article certainly holds true for us, that Red Hat and Linux in general, SUSE is big. Ubuntu server is big. All these different distributions of Linux are being used in production critical environments, and so that's a key thing, and that's why the growth is occurring. So, hope you enjoyed this week's VertZine Netcast. Join us next time, and remember, until then, keep your head in the cloud.